We are delighted to have the Mongolian number one singer, Nomin Jin, to host today's show, remembering a shining star, Debbie Reynolds, part one of two. With more than 10 number one singles in her country, Nomin Jin has also performed in multiple languages to audiences in over 15 countries. Nomin Jin has written over 100 songs and is also an actress, motivational speaker, and animal rights activist who was named PETA's sexiest vegetarian.
Hello, beautiful viewers. I'm Nomin Jin, joining you with the loving regards of the sincere people in artistically inclined Mongolia. Welcome to our special program dedicated to a remarkable, multi-talented woman and true Hollywood icon, Miss Debbie Reynolds.
Singing in the rain, just singing in the rain. What a glorious feeling, we're happy again. We'll walk down the lane with a happy refrain and singing, just singing in the rain.
A highly talented screen and theater actress, achieving huge success in the show business, Debbie Reynolds received and was nominated for numerous awards for her performances in movies, on the stage, and on television. A wonderful singer and entertainer, she was also a successful businesswoman and philanthropist, supporting multiple humanitarian causes. Moreover, Debbie Reynolds was a loving wife and mother, a compassionate woman of steadfast principles and unwavering faith. Today, we explore the life of the much-loved and well-remembered Debbie Reynolds as we celebrate her legacy of talent, professionalism, and above all, her integrity, honesty, and love. Christened Mary Frances Reynolds at birth, she was given the stage name Debbie when she entered Hollywood. Born on the first day of April 1932 in El Paso, Texas, USA, she had modest beginnings with her older brother and their hardworking and faithful parents. Together, the family regularly attended the Christian Church of the Nazarene. Of her humble origins, she commented, "We were always a happy family and a religious one, and I'm trying to inculcate in my children the same sense of values, the same sense of tone that my mother gave to me." Debbie's family moved from El Paso, Texas to Burbank in California, where as a young 16-year-old high school student, she won the Miss Burbank beauty pageant. From that moment on, her life changed. Warner Brothers offered her a contract, and little Mary Frances became Debbie, a nickname given to her by Jack L. Warner. Debbie began appearing in small roles and later signed a contract with Metro-Goldwyn-Mayer, where she participated in the movies Three Little Words, starring Fred Astaire and Red Skelton, 2 Weeks in Love, and Mr. Imperium, alongside the legendary Lana Turner. She received favorable reviews for her acting. However, it was her next role that would propel her to prominence. Debbie was only 19 years old when she starred in Singing in the Rain, listed by the American Film Institute as the greatest movie musical in history. She was acting alongside the movie's lead, Gene Kelly, and had to learn to dance with legendary Fred Astaire's help. Debbie dubbed Gene Kelly a great dancer and cinematic genius and added, "He made me a star. He taught me how to dance, how to work hard and be dedicated." Let's watch one of the dance sequences from the musical that USA Today describes as Debbie's best musical number ever. It's the upbeat tune called Good Morning, also featuring two of Hollywood's greatest tap dancers, Gene Kelly and Donald O'Connor.
Good morning.
passionate viewers, it is now time to enjoy the birds chirping at sunset. We'll learn more about Debbie Reynolds' fascinating life when we return.
Hi, I'm Pamela Anderson Lee with PETA. You might not think about it every time you get dressed, but every time you put on a pair of shoes, a belt, or a pair of gloves, chances are you're wearing leather. And out of all the things that animals are abused for, leather is the most common. To learn how you can help, call PETA. Thank you.
Welcome back to Remembering a Shining Star, Debbie Reynolds, Part 1 of 2. In 1955, 3 years after the great success of Singing in the Rain, Debbie married actor and singer Eddie Fisher, and in 1956, they starred together in Bundle of Joy. Their daughter, Carrie, was born that same year and would follow in her parents' footsteps, becoming an acclaimed actress known for playing the beloved Princess Leia in the famous Star Wars saga. Carrie's little brother, Todd Fisher, was born in 1958 and would also become an accomplished filmmaker. Miss Debbie Reynolds shared with Supreme Master Television some of her sweetest memories of the golden era of Hollywood.
You have been one of America's most beloved actresses of all time, and you've been such a quintessential part of Hollywood's golden era. What has it been like to have been an icon, to be an icon within, across the globe, beloved by millions around the world?
Lucky, I think lucky, because to be come into the business in the golden era and still be alive and happy and having experienced all those wonderful friendships, you know, Clark Gable and Katharine Hepburn. There's so many wonderful memories. I've worked with Betty Davis, and she was a great inspiration to me. You know, she said to me, only listen to the greats. Debbie, you remember what I say. Only work with the greats. Never be afraid, in other words. Always be up to, feel like you're up to any challenge. So, and Jimmy Stewart was the sweetest man that ever lived. But of course, a lot of other people, Glenn Ford, Dick Van Dyke, Gregory Peck, Fred Astaire was the dearest man ever. So that's just to name a few. Betty Grable I loved very much. Agnes Moorehead was one of my dearest friends. So I've been very fortunate to have so many great friends.
In 1957, the movie Tammy and the Bachelor catapulted Debbie's career as a singer, with several of her songs making it onto the Billboard charts of famous ranking musical tunes.
Like someone who hasn't any country, like a stranger visiting from Mars, I would run alone like a rolling stone. Till I read a message in the stars. It must have been
see.
Same year, in 1957, the big-hearted Miss Reynolds was elected president of the Thalians, a foundation geared towards awareness and prevention of mental disease. Through her immense contributions to the organization, Debbie became one of the first celebrities to give importance to a subject that was until then considered taboo. The name of her foundation comes from Thalia, the Greek muse of comedy.
You participate in a lot of philanthropic works. Can you tell us about the philanthropic works that you're engaged in?
Well, I've been working in mental health for 54 years for children and adults for Cedars-Sinai. We've raised over 60-some million. And we have a clinic called the Thalians at Cedars-Sinai. And we do a lot of fine work for all emotionally disturbed children and adults. And schizophrenia and HIV, and it's all psychiatric. So that has been my fondest and dearest and hardest working efforts. I've also been very active in Girl Scout program for years because I believe in patriotism and community effort. And it's important to get our young people that have not the funds to go to camp. That's very important.
We are touched by Debbie's magnanimous spirit for being such a caring celebrity. She certainly has earned her star not only on the Hollywood Walk of Fame, but also in our hearts. Cherished viewers, thank you for joining us for part one of Remembering a Shining Star, Debbie Reynolds. Please join us on Sunday, February 11th for the concluding half of the show here on Supreme Master Television. Now, please stay tuned for Meet Monkeys in the Wild. May the gifts of the divine sprinkle your lives with awe and reverence.
Baby, have wonderful dream. Heaven love you, and I love you. Remember, God, you are divine. Have a good night. Good night, babies, have wonderful dream. Heaven love you, and I love you. Remember, God, you are divine. Have a good night.
We are delighted to have the Mongolian number one singer, Noman Jin, to host today's show, Remembering a Shining Star, Debbie Reynolds, Part 2 of 2. With more than 10 number one singles in her country, Noman Jin has also performed in multiple languages to audiences in over 15 countries. Noman Jin has written over 100 songs and is also an actress, motivational speaker, and animal rights activist who was named PETA's Sexiest Vegetarian.
Greetings, noble viewers. I'm Noman Jin, joining you with the loving thoughts from the people of colorful Mongolia. Welcome to the final part of our special program dedicated to a remarkable, multi-talented woman and true Hollywood icon, Debbie Reynolds. In 2009, Supreme Master Television was honored to have the presence of Miss Reynolds as special guest speaker during their third anniversary concert, hosted by Hollywood celebrities Chris DeRose and Deborah Skelton.
Our guest speaker for this concert. She's received numerous accolades for her performance in film, theater, and television, including nominations for the Academy Award, Tony Award, Emmy Award, and Golden Globe Award. The immensely gifted Miss Debbie Reynolds is a beloved icon of Hollywood and has enriched the lives of audiences worldwide through her singing, dancing, and her acting. She's also appeared in over 200 films and television shows, with some of her most notable roles in Singin' in the Rain, How the West Was Won, and my personal favorite, the unsinkable Molly Brown, for which she earned an Oscar nomination for Best Actress.
During MGM Studio Golden Age of Film, the beautiful Ms. Reynolds co-starred with legendary greats of the silver screen, such as Fred Astaire, Bing Crosby, Betty Davis, Gene Kelly, Gregory Peck, Frank Sinatra, Ava Gabor, James Stewart, Spencer Tracy, and Elizabeth Taylor. And as an accomplished singer, Ms. Reynolds' music has topped the Billboard pop charts. Her song, Tammy, which was one of my favorites, earned her a gold record and was the best-selling single. Many honors and awards have been presented to Ms. Reynolds in her recognition of her multi-talents, including the Lifetime Achievement in Comedy and 3 stars on the Hollywood Walk of Fame.
Wow.
It is for certain that Ms. Reynolds has contributed vastly to the rich cultural tapestry of our world. With a natural flair for entertaining, she has endeared herself to millions of fans with her grace, beauty, wit, and of course, her charm. Let us now welcome America's sweetheart, ladies and gentlemen, Ms. Debbie Reynolds.
Miss Debbie.
Thank you. Thank you very, very much. I didn't know I had done so much. I'm exhausted. I was introduced to the Supreme Master Qinghai almost 11 years ago. It was at the Shrine Auditorium for the benefit concert titled One World of Peace Through Music, which featured an evening of her poems set to music by Hollywood composers. And I was certainly curious to meet her in person after learning of her multi-talents and how a multitude of people around the globe respected her. After much anticipation, Supreme Master Qinghai came on stage, and her first words were, "Hi, it's me." I instantly adored her. She was so down to earth and exuded such a humble nature, and beautiful she is. Thank you.
In 1998, the Supreme Master Qinghai International Association organized a benefit concert for two children's charities, the St. Jude Children's Research Hospital and the Starlight Children's Foundation. Miss Reynolds was the gracious mistress of ceremony for the One World of Peace Through Music, held at the Shrine Auditorium in Los Angeles, California, on the evening of December 18th. Toward the end of the concert, the vivacious Miss Reynolds invited Supreme Master Qinghai to remain on stage for a surprise.
Now, we don't want you to go anyplace because we have a surprise for you.
So, the song for which you've composed lyrics and music, I have arranged this song for some members of our orchestra, and wonder if you might like to join us and sing. I think they want you to give it a shot.
I don't know how you arranged it. You can do it. You go over there and she's going to sing. Ready? I thought it's a surprise for me, but it's not. What if I miss the tune and spoil his reputation? No, you won't do that.
What reputation?
Ready? I'll just jump in and sing Tammy if anything goes wrong.
Okay.
Little musical conference.
Okay. All right.
Where are you going? My winter sun, won't you miss me, staying on this side of the sea? Where have you gone to, my tender moon? Oh, how I miss you, stand on this side, water blue. I wish we could sail the same destination. I want to break these chains, oh my desperation. Where are you now, my only one? Won't someone tell me if you ever return? If you ever return?
Thank you for being so kind.
That was wonderful. Supreme Master Ching Hai. Bravo! Bravo! Beautiful. That's really putting somebody on the spot. For a tiny girl, you certainly have a beautiful voice. What wonderful lyrics. I think this was very special tonight. Wasn't that wonderful and dear of her? I mean, she did a beautiful job. I can't believe she did that. They told me, just tell her it'll be easy, but you know, that's very scary. I was very proud of her. Wasn't she wonderful? She sings beautifully.
Quite a memorable evening it was. When we come back, we'll learn more about Debbie Reynolds. Please stay tuned to Supreme Master Television.
Consider bamboo the next time you're landscaping your yard. Bamboo stores more CO2 and generates 35% more oxygen than an equivalent stand of trees. Answer the call.
This could be good. Hey, you.
Welcome back to Remembering a Shining Star, Debbie Reynolds, part 2 of 2. In the 60s, the movie The Unsinkable Molly Brown earned Debbie Reynolds an Oscar nomination for Best Actress. By 1969, she had her own television show, The Debbie Reynolds Show, for which she received a Golden Globe nomination. But in 1970, Debbie demonstrated that her principles could not be bought, and she left the show because of a cigarette ad during the commercials. She said, "With me, it wasn't a question of money, but integrity. I'm the one who has to live with myself." The issue became a national health debate that subsequently led to the passing of the Public Health Cigarette Smoking Act in 1971, a victory for all who strived for anti-smoking campaigns, including Debbie. The law prohibited advertisements for tobacco products on television and radio. Her loving spirit certainly permeated through all her actions. In 2009, the beloved Debbie Reynolds again reunited with Supreme Master Ching Hai when she joined Supreme Master Television's 3rd anniversary celebration in Los Angeles, California, USA, as special guest speaker, once again charming all present with her wit and lovely heart.
Today we are here to celebrate Supreme Master Television's 3rd anniversary. I offer my heartfelt congratulations and gratitude to Supreme Master Ching Hai and Supreme Master Television for your efforts towards a more peaceful world, a dream that we all share, a reality that will definitely be manifested through everyone's dedication. And now, I'm very happy to welcome today's guest of honor, Supreme Master Ching Hai, to speak with us via video conference.
Miss Debbie, thank you ever so much.
You make me shy.
You're so kind to us and to me. Kindness is written all over your face. But it also comes out in your speech. Are you always so kind like this, or it's just your talent that people love you? I guess both, huh? Yes. I guess it's your kindness also that people love you so much. And you're so beautiful still.
Thank
you. My goodness. I just say to myself, I wish I would be as beautiful as that. Thank you, all the honorable guests, that you take your precious time to come here and to encourage the staff at the Supreme Master Television Quarter.
Miss Debbie Reynolds' kind and noble spirit entered heaven peacefully on December 28, 2016. She was 84. Certainly the heavens were touched by a life dedicated to bringing joy, laughter, and appreciation to millions of people. Her legacy lives on in the wealth of memorable characters and refreshing performances that she gifted the world, and in her beautiful example of a life lived with integrity that was guided by faith in God and a deep love for others.
Anytime at all you're near me, 'cause you're near, you cheer me. That's a very special reason for a very special love. We don't need to speak a word, dear. Still each word is heard, dear. That's a very special reason. Special love. A heart is just a heart, nothing more, nothing less. Just a heart until the day that love comes to stay. And our love will last a lifetime, as a man and wife time. That's a very special reason for a very special love. Yes, our love will last a lifetime, as a man and wife time. That's a very special reason for a very special love. Lucky girl and lucky boy,
it was a pleasure having your company today for part two of Remembering a Shining Star, Debbie Reynolds. May pure love dazzle your days with joy and contentment always.